Hello everyone, my name is Chris, and in this video we're going to cover how to write, read, and manipulate states on Algorand smart contracts. Now there are three types of states on Algorand smart contracts: global state, local state, and box storage. In this video, we're going to talk about global state and local state, and cover box storage in a later video. For those who don't know what global and local states are, global state is state recorded on the smart contract that is accessible by everyone. On the other hand, local state is a state recorded on accounts, and each account can have its unique local state. Think of it as personalized information recorded for your account. Now, this doesn't mean the local states are private. Local states are still accessible by everyone. The only difference with global state is that local states are recorded on the account and not on the smart contract. Let's first talk about global state. To write a global state, you use the app.globalPut method and pass in the state key as the first argument and the default state value as a second argument. This will create and write a global state on your smart contract. To read a global state, you use the app.globalGet operation and pass in the state key as an argument. This will read the global state and return the value for you to use within the smart contract or for external use. To delete a global state, you use the app.globalDel operation and pass in the state key as an argument. Now it's pretty much the same with local state. These are the three operations to write, read, and delete local states. For all of these operations, the first argument is the account address that is accessing and manipulating the local state. Also, key difference with local state is that the account must opt into the smart contract to allow the contract to write local state on the account. Now let's take a look at some code to see how you actually manipulate state on the Algorand smart contract. Alright, here we have a smart contract with the router named state manipulation. And inside the bear call actions, we have three things defined: what happens during creation, what happens during opt-in, and what happens during closeout. Closeout is an opposite of opt-in, so it's opting out of the smart contract. You'll notice that for creation, I'm using create only, so this will only get triggered during creation. For the rest of the two, I'm using call only, and this is used for all non-creation application calls. And for all three of them, I'm just approving them all. And down here, we have defined what happens during clear state application call, and we're just approving that as well. All right, let's first take a look at global state operations. First, to write global state, all you do is app.globalPut, and for the first argument, you put the key value of that global state in bytes value. So I have quote here. And for the second argument, you put in the value of that global state. And I'm taking that from the argument that I passed into this write global method. To read the global state, you do app.globalGet, and you pass in one argument, which is the key value of your global state. So I'm passing in bytes quote, because that's the global state that I created over here. And to delete it, you use app.globalDel, and again, you pass in the key value as the argument to delete it. All right, coming down here, going to local state. The local state operations are very similar to global state operations. Now, before you can do any of these local state operations, your account has to opt into the smart contract. So make sure you send an opt-in transaction to the smart contract and make that connection. After that, to write a local state, you do app.localPut. And for the first argument, you want to pass in the account address that you want to create this local state for. As a second argument, you pass in the key value of the local state, and the third argument is the value of that local state. And here I'm getting that value from the argument name I pass into this method. To read local state, you do app.localGet, and again, for the first argument, you pass in the account address, and the second argument is the key value of that local state. To delete local state, you do app.localDel, and just like all the other local state operations, you pass in the account address for the first argument and the key value as the second argument. So that's our smart contract right there. Now down here, we have the same code again to compile the program and write out the three artifacts into the file system. All right, now let's come to Dappflow to deploy and interact with the smart contract. Make sure you have your Dappflow connected to Sandbox over here. Connect your dev wallet. Go to ABI Studio and import in your ABI file. Click Import ABI, click File, Upload File. Find your project folder, go to Artifacts folder, and then import in the contract.json file. All right, now let's create this application. Go to Create App, click Bear, And the smart contract has one global byte and one local byte value. So I'm going to put one here, zero for global ints, one for local bytes, and zero for local ints. Now upload your approval program, upload your clear program, and click create. Let's first write some local state. Here, if you come to this plus button, you can quickly opt into this smart contract. There you go. My account has opted in to this smart contract, and now I'm able to write local state. Come to write local, and I'm going to put in Harry Potter as a name. Execute. You can see that executed successfully. And now let's read the local state. If I click execute here, you can see the value Harry Potter. Now before we delete the local state, let's write a global state here. And I'm going to write in a quote from the Harry Potter movie. A famous quote, expecto patronum. All right, let's execute that. And if I read the global state, you can see the value expecto patronum. All right, now let's delete global state. And you can do that just by executing this. And if I try reading global state again, it will fail because that value doesn't exist anymore. And you can delete the local state here as well. And if I try reading that, you'll see an error again because the local state doesn't exist anymore. So that's how you write, read, and delete states on the Algorand smart contract. Today we learned about how to write, read, and delete global and local state on Algorand smart contracts. Global states are recorded on the smart contract and are accessible by everyone, while local states are recorded on accounts, and each account have their unique sets of local states for certain smart contracts. That's it for today. Now let's move on to the next video.